I don't know if you've ever done this, but you spend some time thinking about what it would be like if your favorite bands kind of all played together. And sometimes when those fantasies become reality, those ingredients go together in ways you might not totally expect. Like when a guy from this band... decides to join up with musicians from, well, this band. Those are two bands with massive hits, diehard fan bases, AFI, and no doubt also well accustomed with my Discman. A number of years ago. Recently, members of both those bands took fans by surprise with a new secret project. It features AFI singer Davey Havoc, along with Tony Kanal, Adrian Young, and Tom DeMont from No Doubt. And the project is called Dream Car. So you just heard those two bands. When they come together, it sounds like this. Of course, that was a little Dream Car song, Kill for Candy, off their debut self-titled record. The album is out now. It's excellent. And right now I have two members of the band with me here on Q, Tony Kanal and Adrian Young. Welcome to the show, guys.
Hi. That was almost like algebra. The way you know, x squared.
That is literally the most math I have ever done in my entire life.
It was a nice presentation. It's interesting that you chose Davey screaming. Mm-hmm. Up against our ballad.
Yeah. Radio magic, they call it.
The two most disparate things sticking together.
Well, the thing is, AFI and No Doubt, while occupying certainly like two different genres, though they can be very similar at times, both bands are from California, and I'm guessing there were chances of cross-pollination before now. Tony, do you remember the first time you came across AFI?
Somebody introduced me to them many, many years ago, probably the late 90s. A friend of mine named Chris Fenn actually worked at the label that they were on and sent me some stuff. And I was like, wow, this is great. And I've been a fan for many, many years. And we would cross paths with Davey, whether it was at shows or literally on the streets of San Francisco, bumping into him and stuff. And so we've known Davey for a long, long time. But it wasn't till, I would say, 2012 when Black Audio supported No Doubt on one of our shows in Los Angeles that I think that real seed was planted that, you know, he could be a possible collaborator in the future.
And like you said, I know we chose incredibly disparate songs, you know. We chose a ballad and a punk rock song, but I was really surprised by how new wave in many ways this record is. You know, I hear Talking Heads, I hear The Cure, I hear New Order. Adrian, you played, you know, punk and ska and pop and dance hall. What is it about this genre that made you want to explore it?
Well, I mean, I think that for all of us in Dream Car, that was, you know, the early 80s New Romantic movement from Great Britain was hugely impactful. Mm-hmm. And but I must say that when we sat down and started this, what was really an experiment before we became in Dream Car and it became a band. We were jamming. And yeah. It was more or less an experiment where we took Davey out to dinner and said, hey, do you want to maybe collaborate on some music and see where it goes. Mm-hmm. And he said yes, and we basically were just playing what came naturally. There was never discussion of, hey, let's try to be a certain kind of band. We were just playing, and the sounds that you hear on the Dream Car record are, you know, to sound cheesy and truthful, totally organic. It wasn't something that was thought out. There was no master plan.
Yeah, it wasn't premeditated.
It just felt natural. Yeah. You know, that's where our hearts lie, you know, because some of those sounds were from our youth. and you know that'll always be a part of us.
And as much as it wasn't premeditated, what I couldn't get over what it was secret. Like no one knew that this was happening. You kind of sprung this on us at one moment. Tony, why meet and record and create this band in secret?
Because we didn't know what was going to happen.
Right.
You know, and you don't want to talk about something if you don't think it's going to be viable at some point. So it was about getting in the studio, being creative, seeing what happened, and then, you know, once we had some like songs under our belt, then we wanted to share that with the world. Now there was a leak, and somebody, I think Billboard magazine, had you know printed something about us being in the studio together, and that was premature. We weren't ready for that. But at that point, we acknowledged that we were working together.
Right.
But it was still, I would say, maybe 6 months to a year later before we actually officially acknowledged that we were doing something together, when we knew we had something to share with the world.
And you were sort of forced to explain it a little bit when that leak happened. But Adrian, I was thinking that when you would put out a No Doubt record, there's a great expectation, you know, there's a great anticipation for this. So what's it like to release a record with little expectations?
That's part of the beauty of this, of being in Dream Car, because we didn't put any expectations on ourselves. We just basically created this music in the beginning, or at least for a good part of it, with no record company, no management, no outside forces. It was just four people making music. Mm-hmm. And
that must be so different than
it's totally different. It felt like how it used to feel when we were really young. And it's an awesome place to make music from. You know, it's just because, you know, you're kind of playing from your heart, you know, without expectations. I think it's rare, but it was nice to be a part of that environment.
I think that I've read some articles where I've read Davey say that he doesn't really love the idea. Davey Havoc, the lead singer of the band, doesn't love the idea of you guys being described as a super group. But yet that seems to be how you're being described, as this combination of AFI and No Doubt. Tony, what does that term mean to you?
That would not be a name we would give ourselves.
No.
You know, I think that's just an easy go-to. You know, it creates a nice soundbite for people writing a story. Mm-hmm. You know, we like Adrian said, we kind of got together and we wanted to be creative and see where this went. And every single moment, because there were no parameters, because there were no expectations, every single moment of creating was just an expression of ourselves in that moment. Mm-hmm. Like you didn't have to think about, oh, what's anyone going to think about this bass line that I'm putting down for this and this. It was just being creative and seeing and building and building and building. And you know, we would send Davey these pieces of music. He would come back with ideas. And those moments of like just feeling things being created are just so special. And when you're creating them in privacy and secrecy, it's even more special because you're only doing it just for the sake of music.
I also want to go back to something you said, Adrian, when you said that this reminds you in some ways of when you started making music. It reminds you of when you, the kind of the organic process of your early kind of music explorations. And also, I was thinking that you guys are playing the Phoenix in Toronto, and you're not playing the big arena, the big stadium.
Tonight.
And there must be something kind of nice about that, too, about being able to go back to being a bit more intimate with your audiences.
Oh, playing in small venues is awesome.
Yeah.
It's a totally different kind of intensity. Even though it's less people, it's a different kind of energy. And Davey said it the other night in Boston, where he was saying, you know, this feels like 20,000 people, you know, because people are singing the words, and the album's only been out a couple of weeks, and so it feels very immediate. And I personally love being in these clubs. It's great.
And it's been so long since. I mean, you guys came out of playing, you know, shows for your friends. You guys came out of playing punk shows, playing ska shows in Southern California. Tony, it must be kind of nice to go back.
We had this moment at the Roxy a few weeks ago. We did the Roxy in Los Angeles, and we kind of looked it up. We're like, how long has it been since we've been on this stage? And now I'm going to forget what it was, but it was, I want to say it was maybe 22 years since we had played on that stage together. And I mean, going back to these venues, they're intimate. The energy is contained in these smaller venues. And there's something special about small shows, and there's obviously something incredible about big shows too. Mm-hmm. But to be able to do kind of both of them is a real, like, we don't take that for granted. We really appreciate the fact that we get to do this right now.
I want to talk about the two of you, because you mentioned 22 years since you last played the Roxy. Was that it?
Yes.
And that's 20, 30 years of you guys being a rhythm section, of being bass and drums. And are there moments where you're able to look at each other and go like, I can't believe I'm still with this guy. Like this is incredible.
I don't.
Are there any good way or bad?
I don't have that thought when I look at Tony, but you make a good point. I mean, how long is it? I was the last permanent member of No Doubt in 1989.
Right.
So that's how long I've been doing what I do with him. I will say that, I played on a lot of records over the years and done some life things as a freelance guy with other musicians, which is great. But there's no other feeling. I can't replicate, and I can't quantify what it really is to play with Tony. But it's only something I can do with him.
Mm-hmm. Tony, I'm going to you. I know this is the most comfortable part of the interview where you guys have to look at each other.
We rarely get to talk about that. So thank you.
This is so important because what happens with Adrian and myself on stage, and then obviously with Tom as well, the three of us have something so special. We've been playing together for so many years. As Adrian said, 28 years together. There's unspoken things that happen. Mm-hmm. You don't have to talk about things. They just kind of happen naturally. And there's something beautiful about that. And that was the impetus to continue to keep playing together. That was what led into forming Dream Car. It's like, we have something so special. We like hanging out together. We like we had a drink at the bar last night together. Like, we like hanging out together. And that's something that we don't take for granted. That's something that's really special with this history. And that's what led to us saying, hey, we should keep playing together. Let's do another project.
So what about after this? I mean, a lot of times when bands come together from other bands that have been established, they kind of release one record and then they mosey on, because you hear that that hunger, that desperation, that drive that you have when you're sleeping in the back of a van for weeks at a time in your early days may not be there. So Tony, where ultimately do you want to take this band?
We're taking it day by day. You know, we just put the album out. So right now, every part of this process has been really enjoyable. You know, writing the record was enjoyable. Yeah. Then getting together in a rehearsal studio and playing and seeing how that chemistry was going to work was enjoyable. And then rehearsing for the shows and then actually doing shows. Now we're sharing the record with people. So I think we're just taking it day by day, and we'll see where this goes. But we're just in the early. The record has been out 2 weeks as of today, and so we're just enjoying these smaller shows and seeing where this is going to go. We have some festivals coming up, which I'm looking forward to, and we'll see where it goes. I know that we would love to keep creating music. I know we have some more ideas that we want to put down on tape. So we'll see where it goes from here.
I don't want to end on a down note, but I did want to address this. As you mentioned, you were the last member of No Doubt to join in 1989, Adrian. Mm-hmm. And there's a number of musicians, I'll say this, who were playing music in that era in the 1990s, came up in the 1990s, who aren't playing with us anymore. And we were reminded of that when Chris Cornell died just last week. You know, as guys who were with some of these folks in the 1990s, I'm wondering, what did that moment make you think of?
A lot of things.
Yeah.
You know, I think there's a lot of confusion, and it's very frustrating, you know, to see such talented people and, you know, people that are parents lose their lives or give up their lives or what have you. And, you know, the music will obviously live on. But the biggest downer is that, you know, the children. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing that comes to mind for me.
Yeah, we tend to think like when you read Billboard and when you read these magazines, you hear, oh, well, then, you know, we're so sad to lose this voice, but he was a father.
Yeah, that's the most important thing that speaks to me.
That's the toughest part. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's so nice to have you guys in here today. I really appreciate talking to you.
Thank you.
And congratulations on the record. We're going to listen to a little bit of it right now.
Thanks.
All right.
Thanks for having us.
That was Tony Cannell and Adrian Young from the band Dream Car. Their debut record is out right now. If you're in Toronto, you can catch them tonight at the Phoenix Concert Theater. And just watch the two of them lock eyes. Just watch the two of them look at each other. This is Dream Car with Born to Lie on Q.